Why are they calling me Haul? Chris Ennis must have wondered, hearing spectators say, who's that Haulin S in the black number one in his heat race at Victorville on a raceway? Well, Chris was hauling it around the 3/8 mile clay oval, and one of the remarkable aspects was this is the first time he'd raced his new car. Mighty close to being dialed in for openers.
The brand new car that we just picked up, and so I haven't completely got it dialed in. Tonight's our first night out in it.
First time in what we saw as black number one, and we're not likely to see his car look like this again. Look for Ennis to change the number to 86. That's the year he was born. New racing a 360 sprint, but his experience racing everything from go-karts to modifieds shows.
I started off in junior sprints in Visalia, Hanford, and Tulare. Raced those, moved up into go-karts, and from there moved into IMCA modifieds, and 2 weeks ago got in a sprint car for the first time, and now I'm back out here for my first ride in my own car.
On this Independence Day weekend, Saturday, Ennis outdistanced everyone in his heat race. In his 20s, the gifted driver out of Porterville is hardly devoting all his time and energy to racing. When he talks grand design, it's got more to do with blueprints than the Pete's team on his sprint car.
I'm studying to be an architect major right now. I'm going to school at Cal State University of Bakersfield in Bakersfield, California, where I'm currently living, and I'm also going to the community college there.
Chris and Ellen Ennis thank their sponsors, B&B Transmissions, West Olive Welding, Hood's Auto Wrecking, Mike's Auto Repair, Scarpool and Associates, and extends special thanks to Perkins Sprint Car School for their help in setting up the car before and during the race. Bill, Will, and Kenny were terrific. This July 5th, Maine began and ended in scrambled, fragmented manner. 23 of the Southland's fastest drivers, most racing 410s, thundered out of the blocks. Watch as drivers hit the backstretch and hit turn three. Defending Victorville Auto Raceway Sprints champ, John Aiden gets clipped by stablemate Kenny Perkins ahead of him. Aiden goes airborne, then crashes on top of unsuspecting Brandon Thompson. The two perform parallel, a racetrack Perrier that sets the tone for the laps that follow. Neither Aiden from Apple Valley nor Thompson out of Riverside were hurt. Leading up to this, Chris Ennis had trouble getting his car started with the field, so he had to go from starting 10th to the back of the field in 20th position. Keep in mind, Chris commandeers a 360, and most of the cars are 410s. Chris passes one car after another in traffic, and in short order had moved from 20th to 12th. Watch. After frequent restarts, the car ahead of Chris on turn four loses control up high as Chris starts to pass, taking Chris and costing him three or four positions. In the process, Chris loses the right rear shock. He keeps going for a number of laps, reclaiming the 12th position until turn three. The spin out ahead of him leaves Chris nowhere to go. He's rocked by the car behind him, breaking his radius rod, rendering him done for the night. Gotta hand it to Chris Ennis, though, for the first time in his new car, he ran against a highly competitive field on a treacherous track that was dry and dusty, with sand and gravel spinning off rear tires. Chris and his crew will make the repairs, and when he's back, he'll size up the track, make adjustments, and once again prompt spectators to inquire, who's that Haulin S in black 86?